Studies have found that consumers trust recommendations from real people, such as friends, family, colleagues, and even peers who appear to be knowledgeable on subjects. In fact, 88% of consumers agree that they would rather trust an online review from someone they didn't know more than in-your-face company advertising. This is why branding yourself as the expert is essential to building trust with your consumers. Through the creation of well-articulated content and valuable insight, consumers will eventually grow to trust your opinion. Uduak Ogun Jide, right? Ogun Ginde. Odun Ginde.
Odun Ginde.
Okay. I'm so sorry for muttering your name. I'm not Nigerian today. She's the CEO of Udifuchi. She's an accountant by profession, and she's a serial businesswoman. She has a BSc in accounting from the University of Uyo and an MBA from OAU Ile-Ife. She's popularly known on Instagram as Obonge Palm Oil Seller. Obonge Town Crier. Oh my goodness. She helps big and small organizations advertise their businesses through marketing videos. Thank you so much,
Udifuchi. So
please pronounce that name again.
Uduak Odunide.
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 Odunide. Oh, goodness me. Okay. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, Nigerians.
Thank you. So she flew, she flew all the way from Abuja to be here. You know, she was just coming from the airport. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you
so much for coming. Let's just quickly start, Amy, because we really have, you know, limited time. I see your engagement online. And you are super supportive when it comes to marketing. You market aggressively when it comes to products for not just your business, personal business, for other products as well. I mean, you just mentioned that you're coming from Niger Brand Chic, right?
Yeah.
And you didn't even exhibit at the fair. Not you went to support that brand. Tell us why you do this.
Okay, so I still work. I still have my 9-to-5. And yes, I still do. And when I got my job after NYSC, one of my colleagues offered to pick me up and drop, since we're staying close. So on this particular day, I realized he was really moody. He was not the normal Mr. Dakbo I knew. So I said, what happened? He said, oh, his wife just came in from London and bought a lot of items, and the wife just gave him one full box. Oga, go and sell it. You are working. So he didn't know how to sell. So I said, okay, no problem. I've never done business. I don't come from a family where my parents are business people, no. So I said, okay, I'm going to help you. So when we got to the office, I collected the box from him, showed to everybody I could. Hey, come and see what Mr. Dakbo's wife brought. And people started buying, paying. So I was happy. He was happy. So along the line, everybody that had anything to sell in the office will tell you, just go and give it to Uduak. She go sell and give you your money. She doesn't spy when it comes to money. So up to Tiger Nuts, my HR's wife sells Tiger Nuts. She will send it, say, please help me beg Uduak. Anything you had to sell, my boss.
You know, I like it easy for you to get people to come to you. Because why couldn't he do it, and why wasn't he someone else? Could it be because you've just built that capital over time? People just
no. I just offered because it was new. I just started working there. Don't forget.
Remember, it's also referral. Referral. She could do it. So the referral.
So what I say, what's the difference between Uduak and the next person? So what if somebody else did? Do you think it would have been the same response?
I think because when I come to you, how you doing?
So that's the brand.
Why are you not smiling? You have to buy it though, Omar. I'm sorry, I carry your face. You just have so the way I don't come to you to tell you buy. Okay. I just come, hey, how is work?
Yeah.
I have something for you.
So you connect to the person?
Yes, immediately with my spouse. So along the line, my boss called and asked, how much commission do you get from this item? I said, commission. I don't understand. He said, you don't add anything. I said, no, I don't. And she said, Uduak, you're crazy. I said, no, I'm just happy that I can help anybody and put smiles on their faces. She said, go and look for what to sell.
Let me come in here. Ogbonge
palm oil.
Caught my attention. And even when you were interacting with us, you were using your pigeon, you were throwing it in here and there, and I liked it. So tell us, why did you choose to use pigeon language as your mode of interaction in marketing your business?
Okay, I'm going to go back to the palm oil.
Okay.
I started with 4 gallons, the 25 liters. And I sold out in 2 days, and I pushed myself. I ordered 20.
Wow.
I pushed myself, I ordered 50. And this particular time, I got home every day and it wasn't moving. I was like, oops, I never entered Big A like this.
You get them, Sha.
So I entered into my room. I trust so much the God factor.
Awesome. Yes.
So I knelt down. I said, Holy Spirit, what are you saying? How can I sell this thing?
What are you saying?
Then I couldn't sell only to my colleagues anymore.
Yes.
And he came down and said, you're going to do an advert in Pigeon. It was clear, just too clear. I struggled with it because I was doing on social media. I know social media, everyone in a paparazzi.
Everybody's
going to talk. So I called some people that had been there, people I was learning from, and I said, look at this idea came. All of them said, no, you can't do that.
Wow.
You can't do an advert. It doesn't resonate with your brand. People are not going to buy. But you know when you hear God, you know. I fought with it then. I said, no. So this is, I was going for a training. I love going for trainings because I don't come from a business background. So anything that will help me grow my business.
I'm
also, I was going to Abeokuta for a business training and I brought out my phone. And the first word that came out was, Namibi, Ogbonge Palm Oil Mama.
Wow.
It came and I didn't know what he told me. It just came. So that's how that name came about.
Wow.
And when I stayed again, I did that video and I had almost 10,000 views.
Wow.
And then I knew that's okay.
So how has the journey been so far? Has it been, has it given you a lot of income? Has it changed your, from where you are coming from, basically from, you know, just the word of God coming to you?
Mm.
And you started from 2 gallons or 4 gallons?
4 gallons.
Of palm oil.
Yeah.
How has the business grown since then?
Yeah.
With your personal brand, using your Ogbonge Pidgin English.
So at the end of every month, I was making like 20, 30,000.
Okay.
But after I started, I hit 1 million every month.
Wow.
Because I was now using the language, like everybody was waiting to hear.
To understand.
And everybody was like, is it palm oil she's selling? What is she? Is it gold? Is it liquid gold? And like, no, it's palm oil. All of a sudden, people came to me and said, I'm not buying because I need palm oil. I just love you as a person.
Awesome.
You are just too real.
Consistency and authenticity.
We're talking about your equity. You know,
brand
people
equity.
Buy things because of the person. You understand? We had Kemiona Banjo earlier on the show and we're talking about it. How would you say that has played in your business? You know, because people don't just buy because they just want to buy. There's palm oil everywhere. Why would they come to Udwak? Because somebody out there is making a mistake. They're thinking, okay, Udwak is selling palm oil and she's doing well, so I want to go into the palm oil business. And they're getting it wrong. You mentioned something. You mentioned training. Many people don't understand that it's very critical for them to actually learn. If you don't know something, you learn for you to grow your business.
Yeah.
Then also, there's something that Udwak has that they don't have. But they just feel, oh, it's palm oil, I can sell it. You know. And I see a lot of people make that mistake. So when you see people like that, what would be your advice to those kind of people?
For me, the first thing is, like I said, training. When I started with 2,000 naira training. I grew to 5,000, when I hear 10,000. This year, I paid almost 500,000 naira for a training. That, to me, is an investment for me. Then service. My brand has grown on the platform of service. So when I started doing the jingles, when the Niger Brand Chief Trade Fair first started, I sent the host, Nelly Ogbogo, a message. I said, I want to do a video jingle for Niger Brand Chief. And she was excited, and people liked it. So I started looking for people. Anybody that tells me I love it, I'll just come to you. I said, well, do you want me to do it for you? I can do it for you. I'm not charging you. So that helped my brand. I was giving a lot. And sometimes I just stay and I'm like, okay, oh, can I send you palm oil? I have palm oil. You know, people talked about it. I didn't know then about influenza or anything, but when I'm led to give you something, I give. So service, a lot of people don't want to go the extra mile to serve other people. But that has helped my brand a lot. Because by the time I did for this person, did for this person.
So would you say for you, followers, on Instagram, because we see people, they have followers, but it has not equal to sales.
Mm.
They have like 10 million followers, but it has not translated to sales. So you can tell us categorically for you that your following has equated to sales.
Yes. 99%. Let me say.
So how do you now convert yours? What's the difference between you and somebody else that has a million followers and it's not translating to Naira and Kobo for them?
So for me, what I do is that when I do a video, I go crazy, I make it very funny. And immediately you like my post, I send you a DM.
Oh.
I send you, thank you for liking my post. We have this, we have this, we have this.
Okay.
So they always tend.
There's an engagement.
Yes, yes, they tend to.
For every like.
I try at least 98%.
You are
I try
very
to do
engaging.
And I try to be very consistent. I make sure the minimum post I make a day is three times I post a day.
Wow. I saw the post you had with... Oh, go ahead.
Yeah, so you mentioned something, and when you got that leading to market in Pidgin, and you said, you know, people said, the naysayers said it doesn't resonate with your brand.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
What was this brand, and what is this brand? So what was this brand that people... What was this perception of you that people thought, you know, Pidgin didn't resonate with? Are you still, you know, operating this brand in terms of what they thought?
Okay, so she felt that on Instagram you have all the tush people.
Yes.
Right. You know, if you carry your own locality, come put time for that place. She said, no, Duak, forget say they sell palm oil, but you can't do that. That
you have to sell it tush.
You have to do it.
But were you on Instagram prior, and how were you projecting yourself?
No, I was just there, just doing my normal posting.
Normal post, right.
Yeah,
but and you were selling obonge palm oil.
So bonge, I want you to sell.
Yes, so to that, and I just found out that is what people wanted.
Yes.
That is
so
what
advice would you give to the youth of today who... And you know, there are so many CEOs. My younger brother, he's 30 under 30 CEO. There's so many young people, you know, doing their own thing. What advice would you give to them in terms of how
originality.
To project, yes, themselves and how to make this translate to income or revenue, as it were?
Okay, so first thing is, whatever you're going to, know it very well. Have a deep understanding of, you know, that's a mistake a lot of people. Someone met me yesterday and said, I saw you and I started selling palm oil, but I don't understand what's happening. And I said, you need to understand the business.
Why are you doing what you're doing?
I am 2 months ago, I have my 9-to-5, I'm entitled to 30 days leave. I have just 2 days left. None of those days have been for my personal enjoyment. Mm-hmm. It's been from one training to the other. So I tell them, if you need to go into a palm oil business, know about it. Be the guru. Maybe they know saying now you get that business. You have all the information about it. Then try to get this mistake I made then was my pricing. I didn't know anything about pricing. Mm. I know I just felt it is, oh yeah, buy yourself, buy money enter. Oh yeah, use and increase the quantity. So I made that terrible mistake. I didn't know anything about a business plan. I didn't have a vision. I didn't have a mission. Statement.
You just wanted to sell.
Yeah, yes. Someone said, Woodwork, you can sell. Go and start selling. So I was selling. So, and I realized that when I did it, I did a one-on-one on pricing with Trisha Bees. And by the time we broke down, I was crying home. Mm-hmm. I was just doing buying and selling. I wasn't making any profit. So that I always advise first, get your price, know the business, get your pricing right. Know who your target market is.
Yes.
And I wanted to, because you seem to be very multi-talented when it comes to you. For me, when I hear you speak, it means you can sell anything. It can even be this cup you will sell tomorrow and you sell. You know, you can sell anything. You know, so why I'm saying this is, Woodward didn't need to go and start a farm. Because everybody is hearing the federal government saying that they want to invest in agriculture. And everybody thinks that
everybody's
agriculture
that
means
way.
That you mm-hmm. need to go and start and own a farmland. Mm-hmm. You can actually go through the route. She doesn't need to farm it. She's just off taking from
a huge value chain.
There's a huge value chain that you can actually plug in to wherever it is
and
that you are.
That's where the training comes
yes.
in.
Yes.
I was 4 months ago, I was at NIFO in Benin.
Yes.
I was there for 3 weeks. Mm. A personal training.
Yeah.
And that's when I realized that it's more than even what I thought. I can decide to be in the packaging value
sector.
Chain. I can decide to be in the milling process. I can decide to
anywhere
farm.
You can plug
so
in.
So imagine that's where I found my strength. My strength is marketing. So I'd rather buy from someone I know is producing well, high
quality.
Yes.
Palm oil.
And face that strength. Then if you have as I grow, like I've told myself in the next 5 years, we need to start milling.
Okay.
But you know it's going to be very easy for me because I now know
the process.
The process. So it's easy for me to now penetrate into that market. But a lot of people just go in and, and yeah, so I always advise, get a knowledge of where do you want to be.
So how well are you bringing upcoming businesses, you know, like, I mean, other businesses that want to also grow like you, you know, do you have people that you are, I know you're supporting other businesses, are you doing a mentorship program as well for them? Apart from the masterclass, I know you hold some masterclasses, are you doing a mentorship program? So if somebody's out there and the person wants to come and learn how to market products like the way you're marketing, are there opportunities for them to come and understudy your business as well?
For when it comes to mentorship, I've not, like, sorry, I have to bring in the God factor.
Yes. Please do.
If I don't get that
clarity,
I don't do it. Like the masterclass, people had been asking me. I did it in collaboration with a friend. And before now, anybody that came to me, I'll tell the person, go and meet Amanda. She will train you just tell her you're from me. I don't want to do it. But 5 months ago, I went for a personal of an official trip. And I had that leading, and the Holy Spirit said, you're going to do a collaboration with Amanda. This is what you're going to take in that course. This is what Amanda is going to take. And I called her, and she said, Rudrak, I've been meaning to ask you, but I didn't know how to approach you. We had almost 73 people register for that master class. Even as people said 20,000.
And what is the impact? What is the track record?
Awesome.
What? How are their businesses currently doing?
We just did it, you know, up to 3 weeks. But the testimony, I still met some of them at the Niger Branch Trade Fair, and she was like, you opened up your heart, because I'm not going to start and I'll just leave you floating. And
exactly. I told them, I was gonna
if
say
you
that.
Need any information, please come to me. Mm. I'll share the information with you.
Thank you so much. we have no more time anymore. I wish we had more time, but thank you so much for making it down. The truth is that we're going to still bring you again. Even Kemi Onabajo, because we've had a very, very insightful conversation.
Yes.
The goal for this show is not just to come and talk, it's to actually bring real solutions to people, because I know people are out there watching and they want solutions. This week has been really, really impactful, because from Friday we talked about
Social media
impact on businesses. Yes. Yesterday we talked about
shifting from
your 9 to 5 into owning your business.
Yes.
And today we're talking about
personal branding
and how it affects your income and your
businesses.
Business. So it's very important that we want to treat these topics holistically, so that whoever wants to branch out, you are well loaded with the right information. So
absolutely.
you go out and you go out well. And I love, you know, you see, when you know that it is right, there's a bit of truth in every guest from Friday. Consistency has been repeatedly said.
Authenticity.
Yes.
Integrity.
Integrity.
Realness.
Realness. Yes.
Yeah,
so that originality, then knowing your craft.
Knowing your craft.
You must know your business. Go for training. All the guests that have come on this set since Friday have said it. So it's been a very, very insightful conversation.
Yes.
And we hope to see you guys Friday next week, or this week, which whatever.
Next,
we'll see
this
you Friday.
Week.
Oh, this week, actually.
Yeah, it's this week. So we don't know when our week starts, whether it's Friday or Sunday.
It's Sunday.
Yeah, so we'll see you Friday. Remember to keep a date with us, 8 p.m. live Friday through to Sunday, for thought-provoking and engaging conversations. And we love you guys, so see you.